Many people get confused over the similarities between the INTP and the INTJ personality type. In this video, we compiled a list of the many differences between the INTP and the INTJ personality type. As always, if this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to get notified every time we upload a new video. With that being said, here are 7 differences between INTPs and INTJs. Number 1. INTJs are intuitives first, INTPs are thinkers first. INTJs have a dominant mental process called introverted intuition. They are much more concerned with seeing underlying meanings, patterns, and long-range visions than they are with internally analyzing and categorizing data. They experience a state of flow when they can envision the future and analyze what is most likely to happen. INTPs have a dominant mental process called introverted thinking. They are more at home in the world of logical analysis and complex problem solving. They thrive on solving puzzles, categorizing data, and refining information to find the most accurate truth. While they enjoy envisioning future possibilities, logical analysis will be their most preferred activity. Number 2. INTJs get hunches out of nowhere. INTPs get hunches stemming from objective data. An INTJ takes a shower in the morning and suddenly gets an aha moment of realization. He or she jumps out of the shower, gets to their computer, writes down their idea, analyzes it, and then tries to figure out how they came to their conclusion. An INTP sits down to analyze a bunch of data and information. She or he sees numerous potentialities as well as ideas and analyzes them all, trying to find which ones are the most plausible. The premonitions and insights that INTJs get seem to appear out of the blue, whereas the ideas and insights that INTPs get can usually be traced back to an object, idea, or theory. Hence, extrovert intuition is called objective, triggered by the object, and introverted intuition is called subjective, triggered by the subject. Number 3. INTJs want an organized external world. INTPs want an organized internal world. INTJs use a process called extrovert thinking. This means that they like to logically organize and structure their external world. They like everything to have a place, they want everything to be sorted into the proper categories and systems, and they want everything streamlined and running efficiently. They usually have no problem directing and delegating, although sometimes they might think they can do things better on their own. INTPs use a process called introverted thinking. They usually don't care as much about the state of their external environment. They want their inner world organized. They want to sort out thoughts, ideas, theories, and facts and put them into the most precise mental categories. When they get a new piece of data, they just want to know where to put it in their brain. The outer world is far less interesting to them, and they usually don't like directing others or delegating. Number 4. INTJs appear very direct. INTPs appear very flexible. INTJs direct thinking and sensing outwardly. INTPs direct intuition and feeling outwardly. As a result, INTJs appear very direct, logical, and blunt in their speech. They are usually self-assured of their vision and stance and don't mind a good challenge or debate. INTPs extrovert intuition and feeling. They are more comfortable discussing ideas, theories, alternatives, and new angles than directly saying they are right. In fact, it is much easier for an INTP to point out what is untrue than what is true. The truth can seem hazy to them because they see so many ways of looking at everything. INTPs have no problem being skeptical and questioning, but they take more time to form conclusions because they mull over the data longer. Number 5. INTJs indulge when stressed. INTPs emote when stressed. During normal cases of stress, INTJs and INTPs will just seem more true to type than usual. They will both become more detached and focused on analyzing the problem, either through intuition or thinking. INTJs may enter a NFI loop and take things personally, and become reclusive and focused on abstract scenarios when stressed. INTPs may enter a TSI loop and become focused on analyzing data and past experiences. However, in cases of extreme or chronic stress, INTJs and INTPs experience the grip the reactions that are very different. When INTJs are experiencing grip stress, they get wrapped up in sensory indulgences or activities. This can mean eating too much, drinking too much, overexercising, or becoming obsessed with details in their environment. When INTPs are experiencing grip stress, they become uncharacteristically emotional and insecure. They tend to lose sight of their normal detached, logical perspective. They tend to take things personally and worry that people dislike or hate them. You can find out more about both types' stress reactions here. Number 6. INTJs want to apply knowledge externally. INTPs want to apply knowledge internally. INTJs believe that whatever they learn should be for the purpose of impacting the world through their auxiliary function, TE. They apply their insight and knowledge strategically to make the outer world more efficient, to solve problems, to improve the environment. INTPs believe in learning for the sake of learning. They will learn just to broaden their own personal understanding of the world and how it works. They feel less of a compulsion to apply their knowledge outwardly. Number 7. INTJs don't really care what other people think. INTPs get annoyed when their thinking is challenged. INTJs care about meeting objective goals and adhering to their own value system. If people disagree with them, they can usually shrug it off, because the proof is in the outcome to them. They'll prove they are right by actions, by showing their plan works. They don't really care too much about social approval, because extrovert feeling is not one of their primary functions, and that's the function most concerned with social feedback. INTPs create and refine inner systems for the purpose of understanding the world and shaping their own mental blueprint for how everything fits together. They want to use their knowledge to generate ideas and improve things for others. However, when people disagree with them, they tend to get frustrated, because deep down they do want positive social feedback, because extrovert feeling is one of their primary four functions. They also have a harder time than INTJs expressing their thoughts and solutions, because their knowledge is so very internalized and complex. With this, we reach the end of our video. If you have any insight to add that would help others, share it in the comments. We would love to hear your opinion.